The process that we've taken for the deep sampling in this project is we set out the sampling locations before we get to the paddock. Once we get to the paddock, what we're doing is we're going to either the high and low production zone first, where we're taking 6 deep samples. When we get to the soil sample location, what we're doing is we're removing 10 centimetres of topsoil. What can generally happen is, if you don't do that, is the 0-10 sample can be drawn down to the deeper parts in the segments, so it can be misrepresentative. We want to put our deep core into the ground, then from there we can roll it out onto a PVC pipe or something where we can accurately measure the segments. So for this project we're doing 0-10, 10 to 30, 30 to 60, and 60 to 90. We're taking 6 deep cores. We're getting rid of the 0-10 in the deep core. From there is we're taking 6 shallow cores of 0-10 around each deep core. The only really important thing to remember there is making sure we get 0-10 and accurate depth control. We sort the sample from each depth by allocating each segment to a separate bucket. We're putting 6 10 to 30s or segments in one bucket. From there, we're mixing and chopping up the samples the best we can. From there, they're being put into a sample bag, which is then scanned into an app and gets sent off to the lab. The information that I think you should send off to the lab is crop type. It depends what report type you get back from the lab, but most will set some critical ranges for the up and coming crop. So if you can include that in your submission, they can give you some more accurate critical ranges. Best practice in storing and transporting the samples is down to 2 things. So number one would be trying to keep out of direct sunlight. The main reason being is what happens is the soil will sweat and you'll get condensation in the bag, which can cause nitrification. So we might have abnormalities in the results and they might not be true. Secondly, with transport is trying to keep them at a constant temperature. I would recommend that you send your soil samples off to the lab as soon as possible. Especially if nitrogen is being tested. So if you could get them off in Express Post as quickly as you can, that would be best practice.